We already bloody love the Moto G5 Plus, and Motorola has just supersized it in the form of the special edition Moto G5 S Plus. Packing a more spacious screen and a funky dual lens camera, this is one of the best sub £300 smartphones you can buy right now, and here's why. When it came to design, the original Moto G5 Plus offered a sleek two-tone metallic finish that proved pleasingly rugged. Yet the G5S Plus goes one further with its updated unibody construction. This seamless design, if you don't count that bit of aerial banding at the top and bottom, stretches right around the edges of the handset, complete with some shiny chamfered corners to break up that matte surfacing. As far as looks go, this is one of the more attractive affordable blowers out there. Although the screen size has increased over the standard Moto G5 Plus, Motorola has kept the dimensions of the G5S Plus almost identical. That's thanks to the reasonably narrow bezels above and below the display. One-handed use is still quite tricky, as this handset is a bit of a wide boy. Thankfully, you do get some help in that area with the Moto Assistant, which we'll touch on later. Although this model isn't water resistant, you can still happily use it in the rain without much worry. And we've also found that the G5S Plus is tough enough to chuck in a bag and generally bash about the place without leaving any significant marks or scuffs on the surface. In fact, our only real complaint about the design work is that jutting camera lens, which sticks quite far out of the Moto's rear end. Luckily, that glass cover seems to be pretty hardy, resistant any scratches so far. The G5S Plus boosts the screen size up to 5.5 inches, which is certainly spacious enough to comfortably enjoy a bit of Netflix on your commute. Despite that larger display, the full HD resolution keeps everything nice and sharp. High-def movies look great, although the IPS tech does mean that you don't quite get the lush, vivid colour reproduction that you would do on an AMOLED screen. Even Motorola's vibrant mode doesn't really seem to make much difference. Still, you do get a nifty night mode for evening use, which filters out blue light for a more comfortable, easy on the eye experience. On top brightness, it's strong enough for easy outdoor use as well, even when Mr. Sun is shining. 32 gigs of storage come packed inside, of which roughly 10 gigs is already filled with the OS and various other bits. There's still plenty of room for apps and the rest, while you can shove in a micro SD memory card to carry around a massive media collection. There's absolutely no difference between the new G5S Plus and the older G5 Plus when it comes to the interface. Motorola has once again served up a vanilla version of Android Nougat, which should therefore receive a swift upgrade to Oreo in the very near future. In fact, the only serious addition to Google's OS is that Moto Assistant, which is genuinely helpful. This offers a variety of motion-based controls that can be used to quick load the camera, for instance, as well as shrink down your apps and desktop so they're easier to use for one hand. Check out our unboxing and hands-on video for a closer look. You also have a fingerprint sensor housed beneath the display in the physical home button. This can quickly and effectively unlock the phone instead of a pin, with up to 5 fingerprints recognized at one time. You can even replace the on-screen back home and recent apps buttons using that sensor, using an option inside of the Moto Assistant. This uses gesture recognition instead, and it works pretty well, as it did on the Huawei P10 and the Honor 9 handsets before it. Another area that hasn't changed over that old model is the performance specs. You once again have a Qualcomm Snapdragon 625 chipset packed inside the G5S Plus, backed by 3 gigs of RAM. That's a reasonably efficient mid-tier platform, which handles the clutter-free version of Android with ease. Okay, so you'll often have to wait a second or so while your app loads after tapping an icon, while the odd little pause crops up here and there during everyday operation. However, the phone is pleasingly stable, with no crashes or tantrums on shore during a fortnight of full-time testing. Once again, you have a 3000mAh battery stuffed inside the phone to match the Moto's original G5 Plus. This gives over a day of use between charges, as long as you're not constantly streaming YouTube or blasting through demanding games. You'll happily enjoy a full 36 hours of life in most cases, while the turbocharge support means you can quickly power it back up when the battery is drained. Sadly, the charging port isn't the latest reversible Type-C, so you will have to pay attention when sticking the cable in. This also means slower data transfer when you're hooked up to a computer. One of the biggest differences between the G5S Plus and the standard vanilla G5 Plus is the camera tech. That original 12-meg snapper, which was impressive for the price, has been completely gutted and replaced with a new dual-lens 13-megapixel shooter instead. As with all Motorola phones, you can quick load the G5S Plus's camera app in a jiffy, simply by double-twisting your wrist while clutching the phone. The camera interface is reassuringly streamlined, so most people can simply point and shoot, with the option of manual controls for more confident users. One of the only new camera features actually added by that dual-lens setup is the depth-enabled mode, which uses the combined images from the two lenses to blur your photo's background. This bokeh feature is pretty common on dual-lens cameras, and it works pretty well here too, helping your subject to stand out, although it's not exactly an essential upgrade. Besides that, there are a couple of other differences. For instance, the G5S Plus's camera captures more vibrant colours than the original phone. Reds, purples, and other bright hues are very striking compared with the more natural colors grabbed by the G5 Plus. However, when it comes to low light, the tables are turned somewhat. The original G5 Plus boasts an f1.7 aperture lens, which can let in more light and therefore capture more detail when conditions are dim. In contrast, the Moto G5s Plus's snappers sport an f2.0 aperture, so you'll find the results are much darker with extra grain. However, the G5s Plus does offer a much improved 8MP selfie snapper, complete with a handy LED flash for snapping far superior selfies in low light. You can also expect serious detail and natural hues, even when that flash is called into play. As for video, you can once again shoot up to 4K resolution footage with the rear camera, so check out our video samples for an idea of what to expect. Overall, the Motorola Moto G5s Plus improves on the already great G5 Plus, offering plenty of bang for under 300 quid here in the UK. Refined design work, a bigger display, and that same vanilla Android interface makes for a strong all-rounder, while the improved selfie camera will definitely appeal to Instagram fans. However, the dual lens snapper on the back nearly does things a bit differently rather than boosting an already great camera. For a full Motorola Moto G5s Plus review and comparisons with the G5 Plus and the rest of the Moto G family, check out recombo.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe and do the bell thing and all the rest of it. Thanks for watching.